Good morning.
Good morning.
Again, I want to certainly welcome parents and guardians and relatives and our new Bennett Bales, our fresh women, to Bennett College. Some of you have been here now since Friday, and others have been here since yesterday. So I hope that all went well with you, and we look forward to continuing to work with you this year. I know for many parents that today is a bittersweet moment. It is a day in which you will continue to really visit our various offices and see people in order to take care of some final business here on campus. And also it's a day in which you have you have a lot of pride, and you're happy and excited that your daughter is now a Bennett Bale. But it's also a day in which you are somewhat sad, because this evening you will be leaving your young lady here at Bennett College. And while many of you will say that you will not cry and you're happy and you'll take the room and you'll do this and that with it, I know, as a parent who went through this 5, 6, 7 years ago, you'll say that, but you'll drive back or fly back and you'll cry all the way. But young women, they will never tell you that, okay? So welcome to Bennett College. We will begin with the program as printed. We'll begin with our very own chaplain, Dr. Natalie McLean, who will give you the invocation and the scripture.
Let us bow together in prayer. Dear God, for the glory of your presence and the beauty of this day, we say thank you. Thank you for gathering us together today. Thank you for a night's rest, safe travel, and thank you for this opportunity to be in your midst, in your sacred place. Be pleased to dwell with us and let your spirit have its way in this place. Thank you for the words of our president who will inspire us this day. All glory, praise, and honor belong to you. In Jesus, amen. Our scripture for this morning is found in the 27th Psalm. I'll read from the New International Translation. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When evil men advance against me to devour my flesh, when my enemies and my foes attack me, they will stumble and fall. Though a host should encamp about me, my heart shall not fear. Though war break out against me, even then will I be confident. One thing I ask of the Lord, and that is what I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze upon the beauty of the Lord and to seek him in his temple. For in the day of trouble, he will keep me safe in his dwelling. He will hide me in the shelter of his tabernacle and set me upon a high rock. Then my head will be exalted above my enemies who surround me. At his tabernacle will I sacrifice with shouts of joy. I will sing and make music to the Lord. Hear my voice when I call, O Lord. Be merciful to me and answer me. My heart says of you, seek his face. Your face, Lord, I will seek. Do not hide your face from me, and do not turn your servant away in anger. You have been my helper. Do not reject me or forsake me, O God, my Savior. Though my mother and my father forsake me, the Lord will receive me. Teach me your way, O Lord. Lead me in a straight path because of oppressors. Do not turn me over to the desire of my foes, for false witnesses rise up against me, breathing out violence. I am confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage. Again, I say, wait on the Lord. Amen.
Thank you, Dr. McLean. I'm Joyce Blackwell, Provost and Vice President for Academic and Student Affairs, and it really gives me great pleasure and an honor to introduce our speaker for this morning, our President, Dr. Rosalind Fuse Hall. Dr. Fuse Hall became the president of Bennett College on July 1, 2013. Born in Atlanta, Georgia, she grew up in Fayetteville, North Carolina, on the campus of Fayetteville State University, where her father was on the faculty. A 1980 graduate of the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill, Fuse Hall earned a Bachelor of Science degree in Administration of Criminal Justice. In 1983, she earned her Juris Doctor from Rutgers School of Law in Newark, New Jersey. She also studied at Harvard Graduate School of Education and the Institute of Educational Management. Now, although she began her career in law, Dr. Fuse Hall soon gravitated to higher education. She comes from a family of educators. Her mother and five aunts were teachers. And she is married to Dr. Jarvis Hall, a political science professor at North Carolina Central University. And her daughter, Efatoya, is a 2013 graduate of the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill. And she currently teaches with Teach for America in Texas. Dr. Fuse Hall started her legal career as a judicial law clerk with the Honorable William H. Walls in Newark, and then as a staff attorney in the Enforcement Division of the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission in New York City. Her first position in higher education was at St. Lawrence University, where she was Assistant Director for Minority Affairs. Most recently, she served as Chief of Staff to the President at Florida A&M University and Interim Executive Director of Title III Programs. She has served as Executive Assistant to the Chancellor at North Carolina Central University and Corporate Secretary to the Board of Governors of the University of North Carolina System, which consists of 17 campuses. While at Florida A&M University, Dr. Fuse Hall managed $10 million in special programs to enhance institutional strengths and student outcomes. She is especially proud of a grant that she drafted with several colleagues that was funded for an additional $10 million over 5 years. At North Carolina Central University, she worked on two special initiatives that brought nearly $44 million to the university. One was the Biomanufacturing Research Institute and Technology Enterprise, better known by its acronyms BRITE, which means bright. So the Biomanufacturing Research Institute and Technology Enterprise Center for Excellence, also known as BRITE. This was a research institute that brought together the biotech industry, governmental officials, community colleges, and a major research university to secure $19.1 million in capital funds to build the institute and an additional $7 million in annual operating funds from the state legislature. The second project resulted from a public-private partnership that built a 408-bed residence hall on the newly created West Campus of the university. Dr. Fuse Hall also has worked as an associate dean in the College of Arts and Sciences at UNC Chapel Hill. In 2004, she traveled to Southeast Asia on an Eisenhower Fellowship. She was in the charter class of Bridges, a UNC academic leadership program, and was a participant in Leadership America, which is a national leadership development program. She serves on numerous boards and advisory panels, and her professional affiliations include the Association of Black Women in Higher Education. Dr. Fuse Hall is a member of the Lynx Incorporated, an international not-for-profit corporation with a membership of about 12,000 professional women of color who are devoted to voluntary public service. She is a frequent presenter and public speaker. So after a special presentation by Ms. Tremaine Miller Harris, class of 2014, who's also Ms. Royal Blue and White, the next voice you will hear will be that of our own president, Dr. Rosalind Fuse Hall. Thank you.
I know you kept me, yes. First, I want to thank the provost for that wonderful and gracious introduction. I want to thank Ms. Royal Blue and White for her special presentation. Let's give her another hand. I want to wish one of our new bells a happy birthday. She's here all the way from California. We want to thank her and wish her happy birthday. Just stand up. When you come that far away from home to create a new home, we need to welcome and acknowledge and celebrate. I want to thank Dr. McLean this morning for reading one of my all-time favorite scriptures. And I want to thank you for reflecting upon the music that I asked to be played this morning before I speak. The song you were listening to is from The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill. Sister Hill is a very talented woman, but she's just begun a prison term on July the 8th for not paying $1 million in taxes. And for some reason, when I was trying to think of what I wanted to say to you all this morning as you begin your amazing journey on this thing called college life, that song just kept penetrating my thoughts. Nothing even matters. Sometimes your generation appears to have a nothing even matters attitude about life. And why would you? You've seen 9/11. You've experienced the most horrific shootings in America's history. Virginia Tech, Columbine, Aurora, and Sandy Hook. You've seen the rapidity of change in, through technology, new information invading your space in nanoseconds with internet, emails, Twitter, Tumblr, Instagrams. So what does it matter? Maybe nothing even matters. But let me first tell you that thank God you found your way to this place, this oasis known as Bennett College. And this morning, I want to explore with you, what does it matter? I want to add my congratulations to each of you personally for your success in graduating from high school and your accomplishments that you achieved while there. You have accomplished a major milestone because you know, and if you reflect this morning, upon everyone that started with you in the ninth grade, didn't make it to graduation. For a variety and sundry of reasons, graduation, it really didn't even matter. And while many of your friends and relatives have questioned, why would you want to go to a small, southern women's college anyway? Their questions didn't even matter. and thank God, because I'm here to proclaim to you today that you're going to find that your decision to enroll at Bennett College did matter, and it was a good decision that you made. So welcome to this oasis where we rejuvenate, educate, celebrate you as a woman and a scholar. And another reason I applaud you is because it takes courage, real courage, to stand up to people that you respect and love who question your decisions. And we're going to embolden you to take stands on other issues as well. You will find here the fortitude and the courage, because our faculty and staff are here to introduce you to concepts, problems, and complex issues that will expand your knowledge, expand your thinking skills, cause you to analyze statements as well as written information, and convert you from a high school student into a collegiate scholar. Willingness to be in small classes where your absence is noticed and your contribution to class discussion is missed. But one absent woman doesn't stop the flow of knowledge, nor does your skipping class mean you're not responsible for the class discussion and the assignments given. Nor does your skipping class give you a free pass to make up the work. That is the faculty member's discretion. So be present in class, not just in body, but also with your alert mind, and be prepared to engage in class discussions and to question the information presented. This week has been particularly challenging for me because we buried one of the great civil rights leaders of modern times. He was a North Carolina native from a small town named Mount Gilead. He went to segregated schools, but made it to North Carolina Central University. He graduated at the top of his class and went on to UNC Chapel Hill School of Law. And there were only a few blacks in his class, but that didn't matter for his purpose. He went on to become the chief editor of the UNC Law Review. Now, to be on Law Review already separates you from the rest of the school, but to be the editor-in-chief is the highest honor a law school student can achieve. Law Review articles become primary resources for quotes in legal opinions and the basis for Supreme Court decisions, and he edited what his peers wrote. Can you imagine how his work has mattered? It mattered so much that he was handpicked by Thurgood Marshall, then the director counsel of the NAACP Legal Defense and Educational Fund in New York. And Mr. Chambers went on to then become the director of that. He opened the first integrated law office in the South in 1964 and began working on civil rights issues. He argued 8 cases before the Supreme Court, and he won 8 cases before the Supreme Court, including, that's right, that deserves applause, including the landmark Swan versus Mecklenburg, which addressed the issue of busing to achieve integration. He even went on to become chancellor of his own alma mater, North Carolina Central University. I'm talking about attorney Julius Chambers, who was a humble, brilliant legal scholar and used his talents to better his community, and his work enhanced our lives, regardless of race, gender, creed, or religion. Now, some of you may ask, Madam President, what does that story have to do with Bennett College, or more importantly, me? It has everything to do with Bennett College and you. As a nation and a global society, we need to replace these icons that are transitioning from this life to another. Who is the next Juliet Chambers? I think she's sitting in this chapel. In a few weeks, we will celebrate the 50th anniversary of the March on Washington, where a young preacher stood before a crowd of 300,000, filling the Washington Mall as it had never been filled before, and gave a prophetic speech about having a dream. And you enter Bennett College in that 50th anniversary year, the realization of not only Martin's dream, but also the fulfillment of the dreams of our founding fathers and mothers. 140 years ago, emancipated slaves came together and touched and agreed that education was the beacon of light that would lead them and future generations out of captivity and into a better life. And here you are today, the embodiment of those dreams and aspirations. So who will be the next Martina or group of women that will gather together, touch and agree, pool their resources to ensure that Bennett College is here to celebrate her 250th birthday? I think she and friends of hers are in this chapel today. And just as those icons didn't just dream, they went about working with others to make it happen, so too must you learn to work in teams so you can assist one another. Think about Madam C.J. Walker, not just as a stylist, but as the innovator that she was and the entrepreneur that she became. She saw a need in beautifying and creating a style for black women and other women with unmanageable hair. Understand just how we know that weaves are not just a black thing. Madam Walker knew that it was not just black women with hair concerns, but she seized the opportunity and capitalized upon it. She had a plan, retained capital and finances to support her idea. She marketed and manufactured her product and created not just a business for herself, but for thousands of women across the nation. More importantly, she created wealth for her community and her family. Wealth creation. Wealth creation. Not just having a few extra dollars in a savings account. Wealth creation springs from entrepreneurs. You have to work in teams in order to get to that type of dream. Fast forward now to Mrs. Dana Owens. She came on the scene as an early MC, female MC at that. She rapped about her community in Jersey and soon became an award-winning rap artist. She and her crew realized that true wealth was in ownership. So she began producing not just music, but co-producing films, and then serving as a producer herself, honing her craft, not just doing a little side hustle. She became an Oscar-nominated actress and winner of many other awards. She sings jazz, R&B, rap, and gospel. Multi-talented and multifaceted, you know her best as Queen Latifah. She's an entrepreneur, and if she can do it, you can do it. Convert your side hustles into a business plan. That's right. Learn to be an innovator and not just a consumer. People of color are primarily and disproportionately make up more of the consumer market than any other part of the market. We can be innovators. We can be entrepreneurs. We can own businesses. We can create wealth. We need to keep those funds flowing and benefiting our community. As you go out, I want you to look around this community and see what businesses you find. Where's the neighborhood dry cleaners? Movie theaters, credit unions, bank, grocery stores. These are the typical places where we go and have daily transactions of business. So yes, I want you to study hard here because we have work to do to improve our communities. My wish for you is that you will dedicate yourself, earnestly work hard at studying and honing your thinking skills, writing skills, and overall communication skills so that graduate schools will flock to Bennett College, offering youth scholarships. I want them to flock here and offer you scholarships in their programs in pharmacy, health information sciences, biotechnology, physics, English, journalism, psychology, whatever they're offering. You'll be prepared to take whatever they're offering. You'll be prepared to take even mathematics. On Thursday, while I was at Chancellor Chambers' funeral, the dean of the NCCU School of Law said to me, "Roz, I want to get some of your students in biotechnology and intellectual property track that we have here at the law school. Your students are the kind of students we're looking for." You know what I told her? Come on over. Yeah. Come on over. Come on over. But I'm going to tell you this morning, when she gets here, what is she going to find? I can't show her C students without any research work that showcases critical thinking. C is mediocre. And I asked you, do you want a mediocre lawyer arguing your case in court? Do you want a mediocre doctor operating on your child? A mediocre banker handling your finances? Mediocrity doesn't have a place at Bennett College. So we are here to help you excel. You have to participate in the first year experience. You know, I asked this question yesterday. How many of you been to college before? One or two. It's okay. But not everybody's been to college before. And even if you've been, you've not been here. So you need to learn how to learn. Some of you heard this yesterday, and I'm not going to repeat myself, because those of you who weren't here yesterday should have been here. So what I'm going to ask is that the sisters be sisters. And you all repeat for her what I said to you yesterday. But you've got to come here to learn how to learn. And you're going to do that by participating in the first year experience. You see, we have a strategic plan here, and everyone on the campus can play a role in the strategic plan. The student role is to enhance your communication skills. Watch your language. I just told you that people want to come to Bennett College. Next week, the head of the Z. Smith Reynolds Foundation, one of the largest foundations and funding organizations in North Carolina, the executive director, Leslie Winter, is going to be here. I think I might decide to take her to the art gallery and show her some of our works over there to let her know that we are broad, not just in academics, but in cultural arts as well. And imagine if I have to walk behind some ladies, I don't want to have to cringe at the language flying from their casual conversation. You know, the language that's peppered with effing this and that thought I, or that GD professor, he's such a That's not the language spoken by scholars. You can have it in your portfolio if you must, but know when it's appropriate to be used. Maybe in your residence hall room, or at the club, or maybe in the car driving to the mall, but it has no place on the campus of Bennett College where scholars gather. Where scholars gather and can be overheard. Treat each other with R&D, not just research and development, but respect and dignity. Remember, these sisters will not only become some of your best friends for life, but many of them will serve as your business partners. Some will be your financial advisors, and still others will serve as your expert references for an important speech or presentation that you're putting together. Another means for you to connect with the strategic plan is to strengthen your vocabulary. Now, I know this sounds really elemental, But I didn't even understand it until I went to law school, so I'm going to share that with you. But a strong vocabulary ensures that you are a persuasive advocate of your ideas and positions. Studies have shown that strengthening the vocabulary can actually improve the scores on standardized tests. If you begin developing those skills now, then when you get ready to take the MCAT for medical or dental school, the LSAT for law school, the GMAT for business school, or the GRE for other graduate programs, that's one part of the test you won't even have to worry about. I contribute a great deal of my success to a law professor who I helped to rewrite the evidence code for the state of New Jersey. Now, he was a quirky guy. He bought one suit, one shirt, one tie for the whole year. And he wore it every day. Yeah, it got a little ripe quick. But see, instead of me being put off by that, I was impressed by his brilliance and his scholarship. Not only was he a law professor, not only was he revising the evidence code for the state of New Jersey, he was also the editor of the weekly state's legal newspaper. He challenged us to use the most appropriate word as noted in the first definition of the word in the dictionary. Not just when you looked it up, eventually you found that it did mean what you were trying to use the word for, but we could only use it if it was the first definition. So that means if it wasn't the first, you had to find a better word. Okay? And he would take the time to check, especially if the word was important. But I worked hard at it, and soon I made it my personal goal to do that. When you come in my office, you're going to see I have a dictionary not too far from my desk. When I became a staff attorney at the SEC, the Securities and Exchange Commission, New York Regional Office, about 30 first-year lawyers were placed in a writing workshop taught by a consultant that was hired to come in and work for us. Well, another African-American woman and I tied for the top paper in that workshop. The reason that happened was because I strengthened my vocabulary. That distinguished me from the rest of the attorneys, 200 in that organization, and even led me to getting assigned to a rare case, because we rarely have cases to go to trial at the SEC, and to even as a junior attorney win the role to cross-examine the major witness. Investing in building your skills now will help distinguish you from the rest of the pack later on. You have landed at Bennett College in North Carolina at a pivotal moment in history. Between the politics of the downtown curfew, the voter identification issues, the legislation surrounding women's health clinics, cuts in higher education, and the issues surrounding health care, there are many topics for you and your colleagues to discuss as you explore ideas raised from the various perspectives that you will receive in your general education curriculum. Yes, your circumstances have brought you to Bennett College at this time, and that was uniquely ordained for this time. So you cannot take any time off from learning or engaging the material or thinking about the information that you receive from your professors, your academic advisors, and your tutor. So what does it matter? It means everything to Bennett College. You matter. But for you, 200 employees at this college are out of work. But for you, the economic impact of $29 million generated is lost to this metropolitan area. But for you, paying your bills, then none of us get paid. But for you and your questions about the lessons and the curriculum, ideas aren't sparked that help faculty members perfect their teaching methods and their perspectives on the disciplines. That's why we say higher education is an exchange of ideas. We need your ideas. You need our ideas. We need to engage in discourse where we exchange ideas. That's the true beauty of a liberal arts education, and that's the essence of Bennett College. We need you. You need us. And together, we build a legacy of excellence that sustains this college for future generations. You matter. When it gets hard and it seems impossible, write the word down and look at it. Break it down, and you'll see what I see. I am possible. I'm possible. Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. You matter, and all things are possible. Amen.
Now, you all have just heard from our president. We are really, really excited here at Bennett College. Thank you so much for that very inspiring presentation, Dr. Fuse Hall. We are really excited this year because we know under her leadership and guidance that Bennett College will truly, which is already a great institution, will advance to the next level. So again, thank you. We're now ready to have Dr. Fuse Hall to certainly address any questions that you may have. So I'm going to ask that she return, and if you have questions, to please stand and state your name and your question, please. Thank you.
Any questions? Yes.
My name is Sean Reed Smith.
Yes.
Their mic's
here because everyone wants to hear your question. Thank you.
I have a loud voice.
Okay, that's fine too.
Good morning, I'm Sean Baines.
Good morning, Ms. Smith.
My niece, Justice Jones, is an intern freshman. We're very proud. Graduate of
Bennett College. Oh, wonderful. That's all right. That's all right. Yes, all right. All right.
I was wondering if there is any plan to have a bus or some organized group go to the March on Washington.
Okay. Do we know? Where's Ms. Ruth Dennis?
She's gone.
There's someone else.
Okay. Yes. This is Ms. Bridgen.
We already have a plan to attend. There are several events that are happening, and so we are looking at dates that will be more feasible for us to take some students to go. And if your niece is interested, she just needs to contact me or the SGA president.
Wait, there she is. Here she is, Mariah. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. I can also tell you that we've been working with Ms. Johnson to ensure that the young ladies are going to be introduced to some young advocates who are involved in civic engagement and understand how important that is. And the first man, or the first dude, as he wants to be called. My husband is a political science professor, and his specialty, one of his specialty areas, is civic engagement. So we may persuade him to speak to the young ladies second semester. He's not interested this semester. That's because he's working on, you all heard, Moral Mondays? Yeah. My husband's one of the architects of Moral Mondays. Any other questions? All right, moms and dads, sisters and brothers. Wait a minute, I have another. Yes, come on. Good morning.
Mr. President, I am Mercedes Underwood, one of the entering students of the class of 2017.
Yes.
And I was wondering what brought you to Bennett College.
Oh, thank you so much for that question. This is really hard for me. Thank you very much for that question. I'm a North Carolina native. I there's not too much I don't love about North Carolina. I love its history. I love its landscape. I love its colleges. I love everything about North Carolina. And everywhere I go, people know I'm from North Carolina. About 10, 11 years ago, I was encouraged to become a college president. And I applied at Bennett College. And I was not selected. But what that told me was not no, but not yet. If you truly have faith and understand that there is a higher being than yourself that will prepare you for where you're supposed to be, when you're supposed to be there, then what I did was to go about preparing myself. So I made sure that I took challenging assignments, whether they were offered or I volunteered for them, to prepare myself. So I worked as a vice president for student affairs and vice president for institutional advancement. I did construction work. I did contract work. I did special assignments. I built a West Campus. I worked in a team that was wonderful in restoring one of our HBCUs, and I worked on SACS, and I worked on the strategic plan. So when they called again, I said, here am I. Take me. And I am so grateful that they did. I don't know if they love me more, but I know I love them a lot. I am so proud to serve as the 17th president of Bennett College. Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning, everybody. My name is Janae Davis. I'm a graduating senior. Yay. I'm a journalism and media studies major from Atlanta, Georgia.
Right.
And I just want for you, Dr. Futau, to share with the freshmen women, because this is their first year and it's your first year. So could you kind of share with them some of the fears that you may have, they may have, and how you have planned to get over those fears because it's their first year?
That's an excellent question. My husband was teasing me yesterday because I was watching you all from the house. I was just like, and there she goes. See, she's looking at her. See, she's going across there. I've met her parents. Oh, wait a minute. There's some. It's getting ready to rain. Do you see the rain coming back over there? It's coming. My greatest fear, really, is that I will lose one or two of you before we get to graduation. And I know that life circumstances are such that you may not have the money to complete here. If you don't, I ask that you look for us first and that you try to work with us, and we'll try to work with you. But by the same token, if you have to stop out, don't drop out, okay? If you have to stop out, that's okay, but don't drop out. Come on back and we'll take you. And most important thing is to get to graduation. My second fear is that you will not be safe. We talked about this yesterday, and I want you all to talk more among yourselves about it. Keep yourselves safe. We as women have an awful hard charge that we have to live up to as women. We have to protect ourselves because we have to be healthy. Okay, we have to eat properly. We have to exercise. We all have to do a better job of exercising. But sometimes we also, you know, I've been in love for more than 32 years with the same man, but I'm gonna tell you right now, he still takes my breath away. Okay. So I do know what it is like to be in love and to fall in love. All right, just don't fall too often.
Yeah. Yeah.
Don't accept anyone who doesn't love you better than you love yourself. And all other challenges I'm not scared of. We're going to be able to make some announcements here after we count up all of our pennies, I think. about last year's academics, finances, and I think we're going to be okay. We're going to have to work very hard to stay within our budget, so we're not going to be able to do everything fancy-smancy starting off, but we think we can build upon that. So all I ask is that you work hard and dedicate, and when you feel like it's impossible, write it down. Spell it out. I'm possible. Somehow, some way, it's possible. I got to reach out, and I need somebody to push me along. Sisters, that's what you're here for, pushing each other. Push each other. It's not all about celebration and having good times. You got time for that. Trust me, you do. You have time for that. This is a finite time in your life. If you don't capitalize on it and invest in it wisely now, it shall be lost forever. All right? So I'm not worried about anything but that. Be healthy, stay with us, be safe. Okay? All right. Thank you very much. Now, I've been doing this, so I need to let you all in on a little secret. Some of you all have little people in your lives, and I met a couple of them, and they have a thing called a presidential pass. They'll tell you about it, okay? But we have a young man in this class. His sister is going to be in this class. And they came to SOARS, and I fell in love with him. And I am so glad to see him back today. Yeah? There he is over there. I want this class to adopt him. I want this class to adopt him. I want this to be our... I want this. He has the spirit of a giant, and he has so much personality, and he's already told his mother he wants to be a doctor. All right? And all things are possible. All right? All things are possible. Where's the sister? Where's the sister? You better stand up. This is why I tell you that you matter. But for her, I would have never met him or the mother. But for her having the courage to come to Bennett College, this would not be our guiding principle for the next 4 years. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, darling. I'm so glad to see you. Any other questions? Thank you. Parents, family members, drive safely. Get home safely. Call often, but we'll see you.
Thank you very much. We'll now have the benediction from Reverend Dr. McLean.
Let us pray. Dear God, we thank you so much for the words of inspiration and challenge spoken by President Buzhall this morning. May each of us embrace and demonstrate the elements of the standard she has set. Now may the Lord answer you when you call to him in distress. May the name of the God of Jacob protect you. May God send you help from his sanctuary and grant you support from Zion. May God remember all your sacrifices and accept all of your offerings. May God give you the desires of your heart and make your plans succeed. May God grant you all of your requests. Amen.
Amen.
After the recession, you will actually go to lunch, Sally Walker Brown Dining Hall, where you were on yesterday in the Student Union. And then at 1:45 until 3 this afternoon, you will come back here, parents and students, to meet actually the staff in academic and student affairs. And then from 3:15 until 4:15, you will actually go back to the student union in the 4 year there. There will be a number of exhibits and also personnel on hand to talk about the honors program, global studies, and living learning communities, et cetera. They're all in your program. And then at 5 o'clock, from 5 until 6:30, there will be dinner. And then 6:45 to 7:15, parents and students will return here to the chapel, and we'll have our closing celebration for parents, primarily, and the bell journey will begin for our new bells. And then 7:30 until the remainder of the evening, for the remainder of the evening, there will be a sister chat, pep rally, and those who are interested in the talent show will go to rehearse. So again, thank you so much, and we'll have Dr. McClain, the president, and we'll follow the president out, and she will be able to greet some of you outside. Thank you.
Guests of the college, you are now dismissed.